YW SMH special. We have with us today two members of the hit group, the Miami Sound Machine, Emilio and Gloria. Hello, how are you? We'd like to welcome you to our studio. My name is Marva Dixon, and this is Emilio Garcil. And I would like to know, some of the questions is, which is your favorite of all of your songs?
Oh my God, that's a good question. I think that usually the favorite of the songs is the last one you recorded, because until that point you record it, and it gets out in the street and you start listening to it, it's your favorite. Yeah. Then after that, the next one's your favorite.
Mm-hmm. And what is Lança Perfume?
Okay, Lança Perfume is the Brazilian title of our song, Baila Comigo. Now, in Portuguese, that has a meaning that has no meaning for everyone in the United States or even in the Latin community in the United States, because it's a little spray bottle that they use in the carnivals that has like a certain aroma that they spray. So that song is about that. But since you can't translate that because it has no meaning, you have to do another type of variation, which we did by La Comigo. But legally, you still have to put the name on the record.
I see.
Okay, I got a question. What inspired you to be a musician?
Where's what?
What inspired you?
You know, when I was a kid, I used to love music like I love music now, and I really enjoy, you know, whenever we play or we tour, and being a musician. So I think when you're really a kid and you feel like you're playing an instrument or you want to, you know, piano or whatever, you should play, and you never know. You know, then you become really, you have to go to school and study for a while, and then you become a musician.
Okay, is there anyone you owe this success to? Something special?
To my whole group. To every member in the group, because, you know, without them, for so many years, we've been together for 8 years.
I think the success of a group in particular has to do a lot with the solidarity of it, and how unified you are, and how much each person puts into it, because it's really a group effort. If you have somebody that's not doing their full capacity or their full effort, it kind of makes everyone else lag behind. So when you have everyone pushing towards one goal, that helps a great deal.
Do you plan to write any songs in English?
We've already written songs in English for this next LP. It's planned for this year coming up, an attempted crossover into the American market. You know, that's not easy because the competition is really very big. However, what we're going to do is we're going to record the whole album in Spanish and the whole album in English, and possibly come out with a 45 in English and see what happens with that.
One of the songs that Gloria's mentioned now is she's going to be singing that in October in Japan. She's going to be representing the United States in the Yamaha Festival.
Yamaha Song Festival, and that'll be in English.
That will be in English.
So if something happens
there, let's see what happens.
You were the first to know.
That's great. And are you easily recognized in public?
I'd say in Miami, definitely, really quickly, because we do a lot of television. And outside the United States also, because we do a lot of television outside. We just filmed 4 specials for Puerto Rican WAPA TV, WAPA. And those specials are seen all through Latin and South America and parts of Europe. We've also done TV that's been seen in Canada. So even in places like Las Vegas, where they see the shows filmed here, like at 1 in the morning, we were over there the other day and they recognize you just as much.
Plus we do a lot of the commercials, you know.
Commercials, right.
You know, 7-Up and a lot of things that way. It's, you know, it's through all the United States.
Mm-hmm. Okay, how long does it take you to produce an album?
An album will take me at least a year. For example, now we're just getting the new repertory for the new album, and the album is going to be recorded in New York and London, next album. So usually it takes between, you get the repertory, you get the right arrangements, and the studio time, and the mixing, and the whole thing will take you over a year.
Right, because you know, as a production crew, that the shortest time that it takes is when you're actually on camera. So the shortest time in that span is when you're actually recording in the studio. But to prepare for that album, it takes about a year.
How did you get the name Miami Sound Machine?
Go ahead.
Well, Emilio used to have a group before named Miami Latin Boys. This was before I was in the group. So then when I joined up, of course, they had to change the name because they couldn't keep the boys in there. At least I didn't want them to. So we were with RCA Records at the time, and we wanted to keep the Miami name because we represent Miami, because we've grown up here, and we really feel something very special for the city. So we wanted to keep that name, and at the same time, it was like a special sound that was coming out of Miami, which is a mixture of the two cultures that we have that's so specific of this area. And the machine, it was like the beginning.